So we were a loose coalition of businesses. The Western Cape was separately run. Every hypermarket was separately run. Every region was separately run. Their own admin team, their own buying team, their own general management team, and corporate had no power. Not that that's what we want, if you see the end conductor. But ultimately, what you had was inefficiency all over the business. Raymond doesn't necessarily know about this talk, so if you don't mind. So moving the business into one pick and pay, so massive change in our whole business that requires passion and with difficulty, because you spend your life in meetings thinking about change and how you're going to change and what should you be doing, and you've got all these McKinsey people around, and I've got some Bain people who are employed, and strategically they're the brains. But ultimately, you spend your time in one mode, and you've also got to lead the business and try and get the profits going the right way. What happens in many businesses is you are changing. People are getting are trying things out and needing to be KPI'd is probably the best way of saying it. And we've never been good at this KPI thing. We're only just now getting into it, getting it to the board level and the general manager level, and then it'll cascade down. But it's one of those areas where, you know, we've thumb-sucked performance for many a year. And if you go back in our history, it's probably been one of the areas that we could take the most criticism, probably, in getting the business right. I mean, we've had performance over a long period of time, but it's turnover is hiding growth, and growth in the space is hiding a lot of the stuff, the ills underneath it. And we were fine for a long period of time. And along comes Walmart, and you've got to start to think very differently. We've just done some research. We've done it for 4 years in a row now. And we don't necessarily, we beat ourselves up about our service on the shop floor because we expect a lot more from our people. But the research that had come through with our major competitor, not Woolworths, but Checkers, and we look at Checkers and we look at ShopRite. 2 years ago, we had a gap quite wide in the attributes on service and tools and everything. Then the gap narrowed completely, and now it's widened again. And we think it's largely due to Smart Shopper, one of them. And two, since we've been discussing with the staff, the fact that we may need to retrench has been a lift up. We're sitting in a mode of retrenchments, facing retrenchments, largely due to the way we've run the business for 25 years with an agreement that was quite flawed, and we ended up needing to change the agreement. Otherwise, we've got a labor bill that's two percentage points higher than our competitors. So a very difficult situation. We needed to start to change the way people work. This agreement that we had people working in the beginning of the week, ridiculously, but that's the way it was. Can't go back the 15 years and undo it. We're trying to get out of it, and it took us this amount of time to do it. What we needed was people working at the end of the week, where our customers have mainly elected to do their shopping at that period. So it was a difficult thing to change the behavior, and the only way we could change the behavior was say, look, the people who are working in the beginning are going to have to be retrenched. And we deadlocked last week in the CCMA on it. It's a very difficult moment. Try and let the everything come together in the business with change and ensure that it sort of starts playing together. And we'll see now with all the areas that we're busy with, it'll start to improve incrementally and hopefully then get this ensemble going, particularly in this change arena that we're in, that you keep on in meetings after meeting after meeting after meeting, and results and driving the change and getting to where you need to get to. And these talks, by the way, help immensely in terms of just refocusing your leadership as well. So that's our journey, one pick and pay. Big change, massive change, and a lot of positive in the last 5 years, which I haven't gone into, and a lot more to come.